Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Gell, and today we're going to follow up on episode 548. 548 is where we talked about the scroll bar size, and we talked about if you have a short data set, you could basically use the scroll bar to scroll through the entire data set. So here I can look at all 39 rows. The scroll bar is nice and large. But unfortunately, if we would accidentally activate a cell at the bottom of the spreadsheet, I'll put an X in here, and then delete that X. So now, you know, at one point that cell was alive, now it's not anymore. We have the problem that the scroll bar has now become incredibly small. And as I drag it just a few pixels, I'm already down at row 350. It becomes completely impossible to use the scroll bar anymore for navigating to the top and bottom of the cell. In episode 548, I said that my trick was to delete the extra rows and then save the worksheet. That would allow the scroll bar to become bigger. Derek from the UK sent in a great tip. He said, once you get rid of that extra cell at the bottom, then all you need to do is control drag the sheet. This creates a copy of the sheet, and then both sheets, the original sheet and the new sheet, have the proper scroll bar. Somehow the process of copying the sheet makes Excel look and say, oh, well, there's nothing being used below this point, so we'll make the scroll bar go back to the original size. So it's just as simple as copying the sheet, and of course the fast way to copy the sheet is to control drag the sheet tab to a new spot. Thanks to Derek from the UK, I'm sending one of my Excel master pins for that great idea. If you have a question for the podcast, please feel free to drop me an email, bill@MrExcel.com, and we'll get to you on a future podcast. Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.